Grand rising, loves. This is the altar spread for the collective today. And yeah, that thing happened again. So the sacred geometry that showed up for today is octagon. Octagon brings the message of inspiration, movement, change, creating something that is uniquely yours. Now, showing up in the reverse though, which it did today, brings the message of you are caught in a loop of the same old same. Same shit, different day. Mundane existence. And you are becoming complacent because of that. Because you know that when you get up, this is your routine, this is what you're going to do, it's going to be the same today as it's going to be every day. That is a very dangerous place to be for the spirit. And I'm going to tell you why. Now, it will tend to feel very safe because you already know what to expect. But what happens is that you completely lose the motivation for any newness. And you just allow yourself to stay in that loop. And you can get lost in it and held captive to it and become depressed and lose yourself. Lose the real spark and divine nature of yourself. And shuffling through life in that way is not why we choose the human experience. So it's saying do something, dare to do something different, something new today, just something out of the ordinary, completely new, and own it, own that brilliance. Even if it's just dance, put some music on in your kitchen and dance, or run around the block. Say hello to a stranger. Holy shit, maybe go into a store without a mask on, or talk to someone who looks like they're completely struck with fear and just say, I can feel you and I love you, to maybe quell the energy of their temporary insane nature. Because that is contagious. All energy is contagious. And if you can create the pandemic of love, oh, how delicious does that sound? So wind showed up, and wind also showed up in the reverse. So wind talks about the beautiful nature of the element of air. That wind has this destructive side, seemingly destructive side, but also this beautifully purifying nature. And so even in destruction, the elements are creating space for newness, right? So octagon brings the message that do something new today. Even if it's tiny, do something new. Just do something out of your routine, something new. And the wind showing up in the reverse says, be comfortable with the chaos and just observe it. If you can get in the chaos and be neutral in the chaos, like don't go from to one side or the other. Don't choose sides. Don't fall into the old trap of duality, which is really happening. That's good. This is bad. That's this or this is that. That whole duality thinking, dark, light, is going to make things way worse for you in this shift and change that's happening, that is here, that has arrived. Duality is a lie. It is old paradigm. It was created by greedy men so that they could actually have people buying into a hierarchy. So that certain people would believe they were unworthy and endow others with great worthiness. And that has been perpetuated on every level, mentally, emotionally, physically, right? So when you think about, oh no, I'm not judgmental, I'm not an ego. Do you think that someone is more attractive than someone else based on looks? Do you think someone is smarter than someone else because of credentials, like a piece of paper? Do you think that someone is more emotionally adept because they have medical training or like psychiatry training, mental health training? So these are lies that we're taught to believe. I used to be one of those holders of the fancy piece of paper, and I had to ditch it because it wasn't me. And that piece of paper is not what made me a great practitioner. It was actually my innate gifts, my connection to spirit and all that is. That's what made me good at what I did. It was completely intuition driven. So it was an invaluable education, and I don't consider it time lost, because that more than a decade of time that I spent there, I had constant and consistent validation of my gifts, because I knew the real reason why people were ill. So go into that aspect of yourself to become neutral, because everything is the whole. The dark and the light are just facets of the same thing, right? So don't judge it, just be in it and do something new today. And so the chrysocolla again showed up. I'm like, whoa, okay. So I'm gonna extend the same offer today. Obviously people don't watch the whole videos, but if you are interested in coming on Sunday, this is for local people, share this video and tag me in it. And I will choose another one for today. I chose one yesterday. I will choose one for today, and you can attend my workshop at a discount. So I said half off yesterday, but it's actually less than half what I said. So it's whatever. So anyhow, that includes lunch. It's from 9:30 in the morning until 5. And it basically includes all my modalities. And we finish the day with breath work, a sound bath, and a cacao ceremony. It includes lunch. So I would like to believe, feel that it's a valuable experience. And I'm hoping that we're creating a shockwave in the frequency of people that can actually speak their truth and from the heart. And remember that speaking your truth and from the heart doesn't have to be that sword wielding, I am no longer willing to be in this relationship. Or it doesn't have to be crushing. It could be just something good. We are so afraid to just speak our hearts that people don't anymore. I love spending time with you. Oh, I love your heart. Your smile makes my soul sing. I love the smell of you. I mean, little compliments are speaking your heart. How do you feel? It feels good to spend time with you. Really, speak it all, say all the things. When we do that, we start whittling away at the ego, and the ego starts to go away. And then we are allowed to utilize our intellect for the real, real, why we're here, and we begin to align, because the intellect was meant to be a colander. It's got information in there that, as a divine conduit of that intuition, intellect and intuition, You are propelled through the human experience effortlessly. Ego is an impediment. It's not a tool. It's not to be integrated or understood like some people like to teach erroneously. And I'm sorry, I think that's perpetuating the drag, the weighing down of the entire consciousness, to be honest, because there is no use for it. It's the corruption of the human experience, honestly. It's good to recognize it. And so I guess in that aspect of understanding, so that way you could say, ooh, that's not where I want to be. And the more that you shut it down, the quieter it becomes. And like I said, I'm very aware of where mine shows up. Very, very aware. And yeah. So this is Chrissa Cola. Isn't it pretty? And the circle cross of Tenon, the rare intersection of heaven and earth. Remember, this talks about there is an opening right now. And if you seize the opportunity, it will be permanent for you and you will receive protection and grace in that shift. So if you accept the invitation of doing something brand new today to take yourself out of that mundane and allow yourself to observe any chaos instead of being sucked into the judgment of it and speak your heart, you will be protected and granted grace in that. So this is a powerful day. This is a powerful invitation for the day. Can you do it? Can you do it? Can you do it? I love the spread, honestly. Accept the invitation. Sing from above. I love this song. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. Listen to that trumpet.